So one thing that I've that I've said, and it's not my original thought, I might have heard it or maybe I just felt it that way. But I remember that I found a lot of parallels between 9/11 and COVID, and the parallels meaning that after each one happened, I knew the world was going to change in a different way. And 9/11, however you think about that, however you want to think about that, there was a complex that was ready to take advantage of the situation, meaning the military industrial complex. And they and always they attach themselves to the government and our liberties diminish. And on this one, it was the same thing, but this time it was the pharmaceutical industrial complex that attaches to the government, and they work in concert. And our liberties diminish. Do you see any of those parallels? Do you see where this can go? Because we're barely getting out of Afghanistan 20 years later. I mean, is it going to be 20 years? I mean, you know, now they're talking about a Delta variant and this and that. You know, Delta variant to me sounds like another type of Al Qaeda group that they will talk about and this and that. Like, you know, you can bring these parallels all together and to me, I just sit back and I'm like, man, this is just like a shit show. But, you know, I mean, we're living in it. So, you know, we got to deal with it, you know, and try to educate, I guess, as much as we can.
Yeah. I mean, I don't feel myself getting unplugged from the Matrix anytime soon. Me Brew's not coming around the sun to rescue me. I can tell you that. So I'm stuck here. In regards to military and pharmaceutical coups, I have to tell you, this screams American military coup. And my background, again, is in constitutional law. So my degrees are in religious studies and political science with an emphasis in constitutional pre-law. Okay, that's what I have degrees in. I essentially have the written history of humanity in my mind. And what I can tell you is literacy to liberty, I've actually done information on the steps. There are actually historical analysts that go into the process of a silent military coup. And I have to tell you that we have experienced every single one of those steps through this for the past year and a half. I don't know, but my theory is that there is a cohesive group at the top who's using the American military as a way to instill this medical tyranny. This medical tyranny is a one world order. It is not just for us, but we are paying for it. We pay for it here as American citizens through our taxation and through the fact that we have the largest military in the world. So we are working, they're working cohesively with a group of people who have been planning this for some time. And it still involves the military, and it involves pharmaceutical companies, it involves technological industry, it involves other countries, and it involves other foreign nationals. So this is a cohesive effort worldwide. And America just seems to be the most centralized place for it. The reason why is because of our Constitution. Our Constitution actually affords them the legal ability to do all of this. And so unlike some other constitutions like Honduras, for example, it would be kind of difficult to get this all done through Honduras, but it would be really easy to do it through America because our Constitution is very short. It has a lot of holes and gaps in it in regards to legalities.